All right. You know, I've been meaning to do this video for a while. Big Steppers came out 2 months ago, 3 months ago. It's been a little while. And, you know, in my mind, I might be wrong. I'm probably wrong. Hopefully, I'm wrong. In my mind, that's the last Kendrick album, which means here we go. Here's the body of work. Great time to do a top 10. I started working on this list. I don't know, 3, 4 weeks ago, and I stopped because I realized how daunting it was. It was not easy for me to do. What was even more bizarre is as I started working through it the last couple of days and okay, really filtering out what's in the top 10 and what isn't, songs that I thought for sure would be in the top 10 ended up getting bumped out. Lots of them too. Like I'm looking at my list right now. Four, five, six songs, seven songs. Like, there was a point at one, I was trying to squeeze 16 songs into 10 spots because there you go. Now, I will do at the end, I'll do like my, what do you call it? The honorable mention or whatever, and let you guys know what else is on this list. But I think Kendrick's the best. He's not my favorite. MF Doom is my favorite. But I, in terms of writing, in terms of rapping ability, in terms of storytelling, themes that flow through an album, album structure, it's just incredible. The guy is incredible. I think he's the best. So here we go. I don't really know what else to say. You know, it is kind of weird to sit here and think, what if this is it? What if this is his complete body of work? Probably not the case. You know, at minimum, you know he's going to be featured on some stuff, but. Anyway, it's just kind of weird to think about. Odd pause. So we'll move into number 10. Number 10 cheated. Number 10 scrapped its way into the final spot by way of my seeing the live performance of this song and just loving it because Kendrick crushed it. I can't remember where it was. I think it was Conan O'Brien or something like that. I think it was some talk show. But people told me, "Oh, you got to watch this one," when I was doing the album for Untitled. And it is just incredible. Incredible performance. So good. So good. And it's so good. It's one of those things where when I listen to the recorded version, I hear and enjoy the recorded version, but I'm also playing like the live performance in my head with it, if that makes any sense. I don't know if anybody else does that. Number 10 is from the Untitled album. Untitled, number 8. Just a great jam. And that live performance, if anybody who has not seen the live performance of this song, you gotta watch it.
Why so
It's
sad?
so damn good. And it's so good, it's almost different. Like I remember, I think my wife and I actually did a reaction video to it, to the live performance. And I remember at the start being confused because there's so much, not a lot of alteration, but they do change the song just enough to make it sound like, well, wait, is this something different? Anyway, there you go. There's number 10. I'm happy that a track, at least one track from Untitled got onto this top 10 list. I guess I kind of spoiled it right there, right, for the rest of it. But, because there are some great songs on there. I would love to list them off, but because they're titled with numbers, I can never remember which song is which. But I do remember enjoying like three or four off that album quite a bit. Quite a bit. All right, moving into number 9. Number 9 is surprising because, well, my whole experience with the Damn album was surprising because. On the first listen, on the reaction, I remember concluding the recording and closing it out and thinking to myself as I walked away from my desk, oh my God, I don't like it. I don't like it. And I listened to it and I listened to it. I remember seeing people talk about how you can listen to it in reverse. I did it in reverse a couple times and I liked it more in reverse. And then I remember putting it on shuffle and I was like, oh man, I really. And it just grew on me, and it grew on me, and it grew on me, and it got to the point where I felt like Damn was better than Good Kid, Mad City. I still hold to that. I still hold to that. Now, some of you will argue with me later as this list progresses, but anyway, What's even more surprising from that experience is the fact that this song, initially, I did not like it at all. I did not like it at all. And a part of why I enjoy it more now, I remember watching the Mallory Brothers talk about it, they were doing their reaction to it. And with this track specifically, one of them said, oh, well, actually, let's just play it. And I'll talk about what he said, because I really like it. So number 9, top 10 Kendrick is...
I need some water.
Lust.
Something came over me. Way too high to simmer down. Might as well overheat. Too close to comfort. That's blood rush, my favorite thing.
Great track. Now, the thing that the Mallory Brothers said about it was, he said, you know, when Kendrick says, I need some water, he told his brother, dude, that he just said, I'm thirsty, right? Which is a great line for, you know, a guy who, you know, really wants the girl or whatever. And I had not put that together. And there's something about that track. There's something about the beat. And I don't know. I can't explain it. I can't describe it. I don't know why I like it so much, but I do. I really, really do. And it's still kind of blows me away that it ranks so high on my list, that it's beating out some of these other songs, because I don't know. Kind of a shit explanation for number 9, right? But there's just something about it. There's something about the beat, the way he's singing it. I don't know. I just love it. I love it. So there's number 9, Lust off of Damn. Number 8 is a bit of a cheat, because it's effectively 2 songs in a sense, which should already give away what it is, right? This song to me was incredible. Incredible. Because you get into Good Kid, Mad City, you're working through the story, and when you get towards the end of the album and you get into this song, it really starts to wrap up the whole story of that night and what's going on, what's happening to the good kid in the Mad City. And I still remember the initial reaction listening to the song for the first time, and when it gets to the second half, the like angelic voices that are playing over, it's just incredible, incredible. So number 8, you guys already know what it is. You guys already know what it is. Number 8, top 10, Kendrick is, of course,
Tired of Running, Tired of Hunting.
Sing About Me,
My Own Kind,
Dynamite.
But Retiring Nothing, Tires are steady screeching, the driver is rubbing, Hands on the wheel, Who said we wasn't, Dying of Thirst, Dying of Thirst, Dying of Thirst, Dope on the corner, Look at the coroner, Daughter is dead, Mother is mourning,
It's so hard to pause it. I don't want to pause it. This is the worst part of making top 10 videos, is playing the music and then having to stop it, because I don't want to stop it. Incredible song. And those vocals, those like angelic voices laying over the top of that beat where it just feels like you're running and you're running and you're running. And I remember having this feeling of just seeing somebody running through this mad city while the angels watch from above, you know? Incredible song. And then when it drops into, I think it was Real, the next track, it's just incredible. Incredible song. Incredible album too, man. Love it. Sing About Me too, the 2 verses, you know, the one about, I guess it's Dave and then Keisha's sister. It's just incredible. Fantastic song. Moving into number 7. You know, I think overall, my entire experience with Damn, it's hard to describe. I don't really know why I like it so much. And I think the reason why I have a harder time describing that is because you have other albums like, you know, Pimp a Butterfly, Good Kid, Mad City, even Big Steppers, where you can see a story kind of going through it. And there is a story in Damn, but it's not as clear cut. It's not as obvious, you know? And it's interesting how each song kind of plays off another song, and you know, there's like these opposing feelings and, you know, all this other stuff. But also each song just kind of stands on its own, and each song has its own feeling, its own beat, its own just internal structure. And it makes it very interesting. And so in that sense, where, I mean, there's a lot of songs from Kendrick that I feel you can use as singles and they can exist as singles on their own. I feel like Damn even more so. Damn, you really can just take each song out and listen to it on its own, and it's perfectly fine on its own. It doesn't need the supporting cast of the other tracks from the album to give it more context or give it more meaning or more power, anything like that. Like, each song is just really well done on its own. So, number 7, obviously comes off of the album Damn, is...
Fuck your feelings, I mean there's 4 imposters. I can feel it, the phoenix sure to watch us. I can feel it, the dream is more than process. I can build a regime that forms a likeness. I can feel it, the scream that haunts our logic.
I feel like say some,
I feel like take some,
I feel like skate, no,
I feel like wait for
him. Maybe it's too late for him.
I feel like the whole world want me to pray for him, but who the fuck praying for me?
Nobody's praying for me, man. I specifically chose that part because I love it when the beat kind of drops off right there and he just goes on that quick little tear, you know, very intense. Whereas the rest of the song, it's been building and building and it's just got this echoey feel. I don't know, man. Again, like with Lust, I know it's a terrible lack of description. I don't know why I like it so much, but I really do. Really, really like that song. Feel. Number 7, very happy with it there. I don't think it could go any higher. That's about as high as it can get. Moving on to number 6. Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers is an incredible album. I feel like it's beyond an album. I feel like it's a piece of music, it's a piece of art that will change things down the road, but we don't know yet. Because there are going to be people who listen to this album and this album is going to have such an impact on their mind, on their thought processes, on what they think is important, on what they feel really matters in their life. And it's going to change the direction of some artists who are making their way toward being an artist, toward discovering who they really want to be in terms of their voice, what they're going to talk about, so on. This track, I love this track because it's just got this haunting, relentless beat. Really, the beat is kind of what seals the deal for me, but then the words that go with it too, and what Kendrick is talking about in the song, it's fucking amazing. God, this guy is so good. And I know, there's this tendency online to call people dick riders and stuff like that. Yeah, I'm kind of a Kendrick dick rider, man. Not even sorry. He's just fucking phenomenal at what he does. So, with all that said, number 6 for me from Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers is Worldwide Steppers.
I'm a killer, he's a killer, she's a killer bitch. We some killers walking zombies trying to scratch that itch. Germophobic, hetero.
I am not for the faint of heart. My genetic build can build multi-universes. The men of God playing baby shark with my daughter, watching for sharks outside at the same time. Life as a protective father, I kill for. My son Enoch is the part 2. When I expire, my children to make higher valleys. In this present moment, I saw that through. Ask Whitney about my lust addiction. Text messaging, bitches got my thumbs hurt. Set president for a new sacrilegion. Writer's block for 2 years, nothing moved me. Ask God to speak through me. That's what you hear now, the voice of yours truly. Teleport out my home body for comfort. I don't pass judgment, past life regressions keep me in question. Where did I come from? I don't think like I used to. No, I don't blink like I used to. Aqua stares at everybody. See the flesh of man, but still this man compared to nobody. Yesterday I prayed to the flowers and trees. Gratification to the powers that be. Synchronization with my energy chakras. The ghost of Dr. Sebi paid it forward, cleaned out my toxins, bacteria heavy.
I had to let it go until that piano came in because I love that piano. That song is incredible. Just this relentless pressure, just pressure, 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 pressure. And everything he's detailing there, you know, the 2 years of writer's block, nothing moved, all that shit. And then it gets further into where he's talking about how, you know, the first time I fucked a white bitch and all this other stuff, right? Whitney asked if I had a problem. I said I might be racist, but he's not. He's a sex addict. And it's incredible because it's early in the album. So he hasn't really unveiled these truths yet. He's still living and expressing the lie. And so that's one of the reasons why I really like that song. Because you get into it later, he starts to really open up what's actually going on. You know, here, I feel like this whole thing, when he tells her, I might be racist, he's telling her that because it's an easier answer to give. There's less conversation to surround that versus when you tell your wife or significant other, oh, I'm a sex addict. That's a problem. That's a big, big problem, right? Especially if you're a world famous rapper going on tour from city to city to city. That's a problem. Anyway, Worldwide Steppers, incredible song. Incredible song. Yeah, there you go. All right, top five Kendrick songs. I think a lot of you, if any of you watched my top 10 tracks from the first year, you probably know what my number one is. You probably know what my number two is, but we'll see if there's a surprise for you. Number five, not a whole lot to talk about this one here. It's just great. It's a great, great song. Super easy to listen to. I think for me, it's really one of the first, maybe not necessarily the first, because I did Good Kid, Mad City in December. Or no, that was To Pimp a Butterfly. Good Kid, Mad City was before that. I think this track was really kind of the first single I got into where I was listening to this song pretty often just as its own, you know, outside of an album. Usually I put on albums and I'll play albums, but this one I started just listening to outside of the album. So there you go. From Good Kid, Mad City, because I kind of gave that away, didn't I? Number five is, of course, Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe. Such a great song. Such a great song.
I am a sinner who's probably gonna sin again. Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me. Things I don't understand. Sometimes I need to be alone. Bitch, don't kill my vibe. Bitch, don't kill my vibe. I can feel your energy from two planets away. I got my drink, I got my music, I will share it, but today...
I know, I killed the drop. I know. Again, I would just keep listening to it the whole way through. And not that that's necessarily a problem, but I bet YouTube would fucking probably block the video if I just played it all the way through. Couple things I like about this song, aside from the obvious, it's really relaxing to me. And another thing that I like is that, you know, I remember as I was early into this journey, there's a lot of language barriers I was dealing with. And this one was, I don't know, it was just kind of neat in the sense that it made me understand, you know, just saying something like, bitch, don't kill my vibe, can be a mellow statement, if that makes any sense. Like, on the outside, that seemed like something aggressive, something mean, you know, bitch, don't kill my vibe, but this isn't that. This is just like, just let me be. I'm trying to chill, I'm trying to de-stress. I got my smoke, I got my drink, just leave me alone. Don't kill my vibe, you know? I don't know. And it is extremely relaxing. I've listened to it in the morning sometimes on my way to work because it just helps me chill out. Great song. Very happy with it at number five. It could have maybe been number four, but that's probably about as high as it got. Number five, Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe. Great jam. Coming in at number four, I believe, is the only representative from Section 80. Yeah, there was another song that almost got on the list. Almost. I think my number 10, you know, Untitled 8, bumped out what would have been a second song from Section 80. Number 4, I fell in love with the song the moment I heard it. The moment I heard it, because of the bass line. It was a killer, killer bass line. And so those of you who are really familiar with Section 80, you probably already know what song I'm talking about. But there's another thing about it too, in the sense that this was the first album I heard from Kendrick, and this was really, really early in the channel, exploring albums, you know, really starting the journey proper, right? In the song, the things that he's talking about in this song, it really caught my eye. It made me realize, oh, okay, because I hadn't heard any Kendrick. And it made me realize, oh, this is why he's such a big deal. This is what people are talking about when they say he's a really good writer. Great song. Let's drop into it so you guys know what it is. Number 4 for me on top 10, Kendrick is. Love the bass line on this one. Love it. Kush and Corinthians.
It go ride to it, cause you never know when a bullet might hit and you die to it, die to it, die to it, die to it. Live your life, live it right, be different, do different things, don't do it like.
Great song. Great song. I mean, the beat is fucking phenomenal. The bass line, of course, is amazing. The lyrical structure is fantastic. And I just, every time it gets to that part, you know, where he's talking about why is it that we retaliate? Is it human nature? I don't know. I'll think about it later. Take a right, there you go. You know, so he's there pondering, thinking about retaliation. Why do we do this? And then he's triggered into, there's my target. Go get him. Go get him. Right? It's just this reaction. It's not even a thought. It's a reaction. Fantastic song. Great beat. Great lyrics. Oh, God. Kush and Corinthians, man. Super chill, too. That's what I like about it. It's chill, kind of dark. Fantastic song. Fantastic song. All right, moving into number 3. And I'm just now realizing this is also the first representative from To Pimp a Butterfly. Number 3 is very similar in style and sound to number 4. Very similar to Kush and Corinthians. This was another song that really, really drew me in with the writing. And at this point, I had come to realize, okay, yeah, Kendrick's an excellent writer. And you hear so much about To Pimp a Butterfly, but this one was so cool in the sense that it helped me kind of understand his struggle with his own religious beliefs, because he really kind of pounds on his religious ideas. Oh, bumped the desk there. And he shows himself in a hypocritical light, which is, I mean, something that he does well, but it was just neat the way he did it on this one. So you guys probably don't know what it was, what this track is. Track 3 for me, number 3 on the top 10 from To Pimp a Butterfly. How much a dollar cost me? Great fucking song.
How much a dollar really costs? The question is detrimental, paralyzed in my thoughts. Parasites in my stomach keep me with a gut feeling, y'all. Gotta see how I'm chilling once I park this luxury car. Hopping out, feeling big as Mutombo.
It's so good. Something I really like about this song, too, is as I, you know, interact with friends and family and they ask about the channel and they ask about the music, and so many of them, so many of them are, oh, it's actually good music? Yeah. It's actually good music. Oh, well, that's cool. And of course, you know, they don't believe me. I've shown people the lyrics for this song. I've talked to them about this song specifically. And the song is so good, it can't be denied. Even by people who are, you know, essentially trying to deny rap, trying to deny the idea that they can have these deep, meaningful, thought-provoking songs. It's undeniable. The song is incredible. Incredible. Especially with anybody who has, you know, religious beliefs and thinks that rap and hip hop is just garbage and, you know, sex and drugs and women and blah, blah, blah. No, no, you cannot deny this song. It is so fucking good. How much a dollar cost? Number 3, easily number 3, in my opinion. What's cool is when you listen to that and then you listen to Kush and Corinthians, very similar style, you know, in terms of the sound and the beat structure. It's just, it's great. Number 2 is probably not going to be a surprise to those of you who saw my top 10 favorite tracks first year. This song, and I'll assume that nobody has seen that. The people watching this video did not watch the other video. That way, you know, if you didn't see it, you can kind of get my idea. And if you saw the other one, well, you'll just hear me say the same thing, which I do all the time anyway. This song off of Good Kid, Mad City really made me understand, oh, I'm being pulled in. I'm being pulled into a story. And not only am I being pulled into a story, the story itself is about a guy being pulled in. And it really, early into the album, put out there the essence of what good kid Mad City is all about this good kid in the Mad City trying to survive it. And God, that album is just fucking amazing, man. It is amazing. Amazing album. And of course, number two, it serves it so well. The title of the track compared to the story being told and how he's just getting sucked into these things. Anyway, you guys already know what it is. Number two, all time, top 10, Kendrick tracks.
Me and my niggas fall deep in a white Toyota. A quarter tank of gas, one pistol and orange soda. Janky stash box when the federal rallies a roll up. Basketball shorts with the Gonzalez Park odor. We on the mission for bad bitches in trouble. I hope the universe love you today. Cause the energy we bring is sure to carry away. A flock of positive activists and fill their body with hate if it's necessary. Bumpin' cheesy first album, looking distracted. Speaking language only we know, you think it's an accent. The windows roll down, all I see is a hand pass it. Hotboxing like George Foreman, grilling the masses of the working world. We pulled up on a bunch of working girls and asked them what they working with. Look at me, I got the blunt in my mouth. Usually I'm drug free, but shit, I'm with the homies.
Yeah. I'm with the homies. And that whole song, man, that whole song, and especially that line, I hope the universe loves me today. You can just, and what's so great about it is he doesn't make it obvious. He doesn't tell you, I'm out of control, I have no control, I'm swept up in this thing. He doesn't tell you directly. He just drops these little hints. In that line, I hope the universe loves me today. It's just, it's almost a prayer, you know? Oh, fuck. I'm out of control again. I'm with my friends. I'm caught up in this thing. I don't want to be here. I know I'm going to end up somewhere where, you know, this isn't where I want to be. This isn't what I want to do. Probably going to have some problems. I hope it works out. I hope it works out because it's now beyond my control. It's just incredible. It's incredible, man. Huh. Great song. Such a great song. And then the beat, too, man. The beat is just fucking fantastic. Art of Peer Pressure, number two. Easily number two. Easily. Just a killer, killer song. Well, number one, everybody knows. I'm assuming everybody knows. For those of you who don't know, you didn't see the other video, then that's fine. I'm just going to play it rather than talk about it. I'll talk about it at the end because number one, by far, for me, favorite Kendrick track, Crown. Easily my favorite track.
You walk around like everything is in control. Favor come with favors and you can't say no. Go out the way to make the coin available. That's what I call love.
Something I've come to realize too about that line, that's what I call love. He's talking about, you know, all the ways that the fans regard him and his friends and family treat, well, not necessarily family, but, you know, nod your head and they praise your name across the nation, you know, nod their head and tap the foot in confirmation. And that's what I call love. This is how people love me. But then he's got this other line, love's going to get you killed, right? Trying to serve to these things is going to get you killed. And I don't really think he means that in a literal sense. I kind of think it's more of maybe a spiritual sense, an emotional sense of, if I keep trying to serve this life to reciprocate the love that I'm getting from everybody else, right? It's going to kill me. It's going to kill me. I can't please everybody. I can't please everybody. Fantastic song, man. It cracks me up that even now I'll still get emotional talking about it because think about, you know, just these top 10. You know, the albums that Kendrick has made and the music he's put out and the things that he said, for him to finally get to that point, I can't please everybody. I can't please everybody. For him to finally let it go. It's just awesome. It's incredible. And it's something that I hope people can take into their own life, into consideration, and how they approach things and how they respond to people. And you can't please everybody. You just can't. You can't please everybody. It's an incredible song. And of all the Kendrick songs, it's probably the most simple. He's not even rapping. Super simple beat with the piano. I mean, it's incredible. It's a beautiful piece of music. I still enrage when I think about Anthony Fantano saying it was probably his most annoying song. Oh my fucking God, dude. I still almost kind of lose my mind anytime I think about that. So I don't think about it because it just blows my lid. There you go. There's my top 10 Kendrick songs. No apologies either. All of those are just phenomenal. So what are some honorable mentions, right? What are the ones that are on this list that you guys aren't seeing? So this is not in any order, okay? These are just some contenders. And I actually was going through and I was deleting some tracks. I don't remember which ones I deleted, but I was trying to clean up the list because it was just difficult to manage. Here's some songs, no particular order. Keisha's song, fantastic. Fantastic song. Wesley's Theory, The Black of the Berry, Pride, Good Kid, Fear. Fear was actually going to be in the top 10. I really, really like that song. However, the reason why I got bumped out was because, you know, it's got the sample of the phone call. It's kind of a slower burn. It takes a while to get to that point, but I love the part where it drops into where I'm talking fear, you know, and when he really starts to hammer home these fears that he has, it's just phenomenal. Rigor Mortis, Absol's outro. That might be a surprise to some of you, but I really like that track. Absol's outro. And of course, Mad City. That's a great jam too, man. There you go. Top 10 Kendrick. I'm curious if any of you have tried to make a top 10 Kendrick list because it is challenging. So if you're willing to share your top 10 in the comments, please do. I'd love to see it. It's always fun to see people go back and forth on, you know, which one's their favorite and which one isn't, and how could that be number 4 when it's supposed to be number 1 or number 10 or whatever. You know, it's fun. It's interesting conversation. And I guess that's it. All right, guys. Take care. We'll see you.